So if you've worked in digital art, then maybe you're aware of something called vectors. And no, they're not just transparent drawings, don't believe the lies that DeviantArt tells you. A vector is an image without pixel dimensions. It can literally be any size, and it's most common in animation as well as in super high resolution printing, in graphic design, and stuff like that. But Clip Studio Paint also has vector layers that are different from vector layers in any other program that I've seen so far, and they're good. They're very good, so you should probably learn how to use them if you use Clip Studio Paint. So I'm going to show you how they work. So what is a vector? A vector is basically an image that does not have any size to it. It can be any size, and it's not defined by pixels, it's defined by paths and like little mathematical splines and things like that. You don't need to know the details. Just know that they just don't have a size, that they can be any size. In this respect, Clip Studio Paint's vector layers are not actually true vectors because you cannot export as an actual vector format. First up, see this button. Says new vector layer. Click it. Vector layers in CSP behave just like any other raster layer, except they can't do fills. That's about it. So say you want to do a sketch or some line art or something like that. Do it in a vector layer. Later you decide that you want to make it into a print or a high resolution image. Well, guess what? Because you did it in a vector layer, you don't have to redraw anything. You can just scale it up and it will look exactly the same without any quality loss. Same even applies to the transform tool. And the fun doesn't stop there, there's also a host of other tools for modifying vector layers. Object selection tools allow you to grab individual strokes and move them around. This is very useful for those certain strokes that come out otherwise perfect but are just slightly offset. It's also very useful if you need to clean up certain strokes that you didn't mean to draw. There are also vector eraser tools which erase the entirety of a stroke up to any intersection. So you can do stuff like this. This makes doing hair stupidly easy. You can also optionally set it up to look at only one layer or all layers. Also, there's an entire tool category dedicated just to doing vector layers. It's called the correct line group. You can use this to tweak individual control points, nudge them with the pinch tool, simplify them, which reduces the number of nodes and makes them easier to edit. But the most common tool I use is called the connect vector line, which allows you to turn two strokes into a single one, which is very useful when doing color. There's also the redraw vector line and redraw vector line width. First one does what it sounds like, and the second one allows you to redo a line's pressure without modifying its path, which I actually use a lot for correcting my line art thickness. All the figure drawing tools also still work on vector layers, they just won't do fills. They'll still create the vector paths. Anything that draws a line will make a path even if it's a transparent line. So keep that in mind when you're using the brush tool as well. All in all, vector layers are a huge asset for line art and you should use them. One thing vector layers also work incredibly well with is the reference layer, which is not actually a layer itself, it's actually a setting that you can enable for any layer. This is very useful for doing line art. So to get started, just click the vector layer and click this lighthouse button to enable it as the reference layer. Now what we can do is on any of our tools, we can set it up to not exceed the reference layer line. When it comes to vector layers, you can also set this up to go up to the center of the line rather than just the edge. And this is where vector layers really come into their own versus raster line art. This basically makes coloring a hell of a lot faster, like faster than I could come up with a catchy line to actually describe this. Shit. By holding control and clicking the layers, you can set multiple layers as references as well, which is kind of useful. I also personally set up my tools to only look at the reference layer and not actually care about what's currently on the layer. This will work with the fill tool, the selection tool, brush tools, and more. Personally, I don't use reference layers with brushes all that much. I mostly use the selection and fill tools. Sometimes, especially with really thin line art, you'll get little gaps or edges that don't look very nice, but you can overcome this by tweaking some of the settings, a little bit of practice, or even just manually touching it up with normal brushwork. Reference layers overall make everything a hell of a lot easier. In fact, a lot of CSP's tools all revolve around efficiency and basically just making things faster. So yeah, I hope this is useful. I know I use all this stuff a hell of a lot, so enjoy. Well, this was a short tutorial, but it was one I was meaning to get out for quite a while. Thank you to my patrons for the support, you are all wonderful people. If you want to help me make tutorials like this, feel free to support me on Patreon, no pressure. Just do know that it's 18 plus and it's for the exact same reasons that you're thinking of. Anyway, new animation coming soon, probably within the next month. I'm not exceedingly active on YouTube, so if you want to see more of my stuff, just follow me on Twitter or Tumblr or wherever.
Okay, bye!